try to cover the big move after.
Oh yeah, this is so much better.
I'll just try to stand over here out of the way.
Okay.
Just work efficiently and quickly, but also try to be quiet.
Yeah.
And
I also don't have to say anything. I just thought, you know, if we have a audience, it's nice.
I think that's great. Yeah. We're encouraging them to have audience there.
Right, for that.
Yeah.
We're just kind of more, oh, there's one. We have an audience.
Yay! Okay, well, the live stream is good to go. And I can adjust levels and stuff as needed, but
how does it look? Okay.
It looks pretty good. I started the stream just to see what the video looks like, but the video looks
that's
good because I got a webcam from the library.
We get it a little bit higher?
So that we can
not have the stage at all. You know, like just I think it's
that's
good,
better.
Right?
Yeah, so it'll be more flattering, frankly.
Can you get it from the bar?
I'll try.
Yeah, but that's
there we go. Oh, that looks nice.
That does look nice. Look, Jack is coming.
He's in pink. Yeah, this looks good. Hopefully, the sound is going to be good. Oh, how did they kick you out? Okay. Let's see.
So, everyone, I don't think there doesn't seem to be a green room for us, which is.
Oh, that's cool.
Usually the case, I just assume, and hopefully it's okay that we don't have that. But I would say just be out here, listening to and supporting your colleagues, you know, until like a piece or two before you have to go on, and then you can go out back and just be ready backstage. Does that sound okay?
Mm-hmm. Shall I see if we can get the harp studio if there's nobody in there?
That's possible too. Okay. Yeah, that's great.
Is that a?
But then otherwise, there's a few bigger changeovers that are going to happen. Most of it is not a big thing. It's all from the same setup. So if there is stuff that needs to happen, just let the percussionists basically take care of their business first. We'll come back there, and you'll all walk out together. You carry your music, your flute, whatever, with you, so that doesn't end up being an extra complication. Everyone bows at the beginning. Pick someone to like lead it and take a bow at the end. You'll go off and on between every piece. I mean, that's obvious. We're on the plane. But a lot of this stuff is very obvious. I just want to make sure that the level that you're playing at right now is matched by the level of like professionalism and confidence that you have with your stage presence coming on and off and all of those kinds of things so that you don't have to make up collateral, which you're going to do, but it starts off like you know what you're doing, and you finish like you know what you're doing, because you just did great. Does anyone have any questions about the order of events, or housekeeping?
We have a practice room, so I guess we can go in order, like if someone needs to warm up.
Is the practice room close by?
Yeah, it's around the corner.
Okay, because you could use my studio, too, for the spot.
Where's the practice room?
Right around the corner.
Okay. Is there like
a dancers?
Who needs them? Yeah.
That's our person.
Cool. And Matthew and Giorgio know about coming on, bowing, and
yes,
then taking a seat. Okay.
Oh, I bought red lipstick in case I decide to sell red or blood. I'm like, I'm good. Love. Bright red. This is good. Yeah. If only Matt had like a leather jacket. That would have been so funny. I don't know, where is he?
I don't know.
Emerson says funny things. Nothing but gravy, right? Wasn't it there? It's just gravy. It's just like something involving
gravy. And I'm like, what are you saying?
So, Jolabe folks can go backstage now. Maybe we'll start like 3 minutes. Well, have them read.
So I should.
I'm going to sit there.
So what are we doing?
There are programs out by the entrance. So if you want a program to like check the order and stuff, I'll be kind of in and out here adjusting levels if I have to, but my mom hasn't said it. She's usually like the one who lets me know how the live stream is. But she might be. I should call her. I don't know. I think they all went kind of in the hallway.
Yeah, we're gonna see here.
Hi, are you on the live stream? Yeah, because the first group is starting in a minute, and I need to know how the audio level is. Yeah. I hear Dad playing piano.
If you guys are good, you should get off the stage.
Yeah.
I mean, nobody's playing right now, so I guess just text me how it is, because the first group's going to go on soon. I know. So just, yeah, text me. Fix stuff. Okay. Okay, cool beans. All right, text me, let me know. Bye bye.
So first I'm just going to get it.
Everybody's okay? I'm just going to talk from the back.
collaboration concert for our online audience. I'm Marina Piccinini, and I have the pleasure of leading the flute department. And this is a very exciting event for me specifically. When I first started teaching for all the students, and don't know this either, when I first started teaching at Peabody many years ago, one of the very first people I met here was Bob Van Sykes. And I was tremendously inspired by him, by his energy, by the incredible percussion studio he had built up. And we began immediately, and I'm going back 20 years, we began immediately to say, wow, this is the best collaboration. We need to do a concert together. And over the years, we tried every single year. We had the best assistants here, there. We had all the big, great ideas. It never happened. Never happened. Until last year, when Jeff Stern took the reins and made this thing happen. And I don't know, for me, it's such a very special collaboration. The flute is such a central lyrical instrument, and the percussion has this amazing kaleidoscope of sounds and textures and lyricism, and this percussion studio is absolutely magnificent. Bob has built up really a premier percussion studio. You should all be so incredibly proud to be part of this group. Over the years, my students have, of course, always collaborated with the percussionists. And even I have, as the students got older and professionals, we're working together all the time. It's such a joy and such a pleasure. But to have this happen within every member of the flute studio, every member of the percussion studio, is really incredible. And this year, like last year, Jeff Stern and Jisoo Joan have been really working very, very hard with them, with all everyone, and coaching them. Last night, or the day before, we had a dress rehearsal. I was so impressed and touched and inspired by all the incredible insights and comments that Jeff was giving to everybody. Not only do my students learn a lot, I learn a lot, so thank you so much for that. Bob is a legend and a giant in the percussion world. He has spawned more of the amazing percussionists that are making careers all over the world. He's not here tonight, and also very sadly, he is going to step down after many, many years of teaching here. And I personally wanted to make this a little bit of a tribute to him, to thank him for his collegial camaraderie with me all these years, for producing these great percussionists to play with my great flutists. And I just think it's the most fantastic event. So we have a great program, a long program, no intermission, I hope you will enjoy it, and we'll see you next year as well. This is an ongoing thing. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.
I'm going to try not to shout at you, although I'm going to speak really loudly to cover up the sound of all the moving behind you. This is the biggest move program. Most of it should move smoothly from piece to piece. But A, I just want to thank you and echo Marina in saying we're glad you're joining us tonight, that this program has been so much fun to put together. And it's been a huge learning opportunity for, I think, the students, but also for us. I'm always touched by someone like Marina talking so humbly about people like Bob and her students and our students and all the people that we work with, because she's a rock star herself and has this huge international career that we're so privileged to be able to work with people like Marina. So let's thank Marina. I'm really glad that this collaboration started to happen. We want to keep it going for sure. Aside from the rock starness of Marina and how great our students play in the percussion studio, it is a really natural fit because we've got two of the oldest, kind of most primitive, primal instruments possible, right? People have been hitting drums and hitting things since the beginning of time, and people have been carving flutes out of whatever they have at their disposal. And tonight's program even has kind of a nod to the different cultures that these instruments come from. You're going to hear some Indian-inspired music from Ravi Shankar, and we have some more orchestral themed music, and then we have music that's come through to be infused with today's vernacular, with people like Allison Moggins Hall, who plays in a kind of hip hop flute duo, the Flute Sonics, and this is going to be a little bit more rock and roll inspired. So this program really runs the gamut of style and aesthetic, and through that, it's also just an amazing opportunity for the students to kind of play with other people that are incredible level musicians, but also just make sound in a different way, right? So when percussionists are playing everything really vertically, and that's the way that we make music, that comes with certain things. And so to play with other people who make music in a completely different way, such as blowing air across an opening in a tube, you know, it forces us to kind of change the way that we relate to our own music making and our own instruments. And for me personally, that's a great inspiration of trying to play differently, to try to make my percussion playing sound more flute-like or more vocal or something. And hopefully for the flutists that have done such a great job with this program, it kind of pulls them into a little bit more rhythm making and a different way of music, thinking about music and participating in music that the percussionists do on a daily basis. So it's a beautiful marriage of those kind of ways of playing and approaches, and it kind of brings out the best in everybody. And again, I'm just really covering, so are we almost there, guys?
Yeah.
Okay, we're getting really close. And we're also joined tonight by singer Sophia's going to join us later. That's talking about the oldest, kind of most primitive instruments possible. The voice is something that every instrument is trying to aspire to. And so we're going to include a little bit of voice in the party here. And other than that, I think I get to shut up now. So thank you again for being here. And with that, I'm going to bring out some Ibert.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
Oh, this is better.
And strange.